In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, wa al-Gadami, kul salam wa tayyibin. We missed seeing you last year. Nishkur Rabbina. Allowing us to take the blessing of St. Mary, especially the church here is after the name of St. Mary, the Theotokos, and the blessings of the fathers. Kullum taban dear fathers, and Abuna Kronos Bizet is a dear father and brother since 1991. Yeah, you came 90, I mean it was also 91, exactly. Yeah, and this could have been. Abuna Mark told me something nice since St. Mary's fast is for 2 weeks, so I think the fathers thought to have a Bible study and they thought to have an idea about the epistles of St. Paul, because there are 14 of them. So I think the father thought that's every day to reflect in one of the epistles. So, God willing, I understand that Abuna, yesterday you spoke about the first epistle, like in the Bible, our Bible, the epistle of St. Paul to the Romans. And today we'll speak about the epistle of St. Paul to Corinthians, 1 Corinthians. We're going to have a quick recap, what is the epistle is all about. And then maybe we reflect for a few minutes in a couple of verses in certain chapters. It's important to understand that the order of the books in the Bible is not chronological. يعني الترتيب مش زمني, but with certain logic. So Romans was the biggest and very important. That's why it's the first epistle. Probably Abuna last night told you this. Corinthians is 16 chapter. That's why it comes right after Romans. But in reality, it's written actually the third or the fourth epistle. Okay? We're not going to go much into history and geography, not to lose your focus. But at least we have a quick understanding. Corinth is basically a city in southern Greece, and in the Bible terms, you're gonna hear a lot of time when you read, you hear Achaia, right? And Macedonia, or Macedonia. Macedonia, Achaia. Basically, Achaia is upper Greece, and Macedonia is lower Greece is Achaia, and Macedonia is in the upper area, okay? St. Paul visited Corinth in his second missionary trip. يعني في الرحلة الثانية بولس الرسول الرحلة الأولى راح آسيا الصغرى الرحلة الثانية راح يونان. Second trip, he went to Greece. And over there, he went from the north Philippi, went all the way down to Corinth, okay? That was in his second journey. And there, he preached Christianity. And he established Christianity in his second missionary trip. So I don't know if you're going to have a Q&A by the end of the 2 weeks or not. So you should know that Corinth, St. Paul preached there in the second missionary trip. Then in the third missionary trip, when St. Paul went to Ephesus in Asia Minor, over there he wrote the epistle to the Corinthians. So the epistle, St. Paul to Corinthians, was written from Asia Minor. St. Paul was where? In Ephesus, writing to Corinthians. Okay, this is a يعني, quick outline. That's what we said, okay? And this is a map just to understand. So you see, Corinth is the southern part of Greece. And if you go all the way up, you fit Philippi, okay? And if you go eastward, this is where St. Paul was in Ephesus, and he wrote the epistle. يعني هو القديس بولس الرسول كتبها في الرحلة الثالثة. هو كان بشر أهل كرونسوس في رحلته التبشيرية الثانية. في الرحلة الثالثة هو قاعد في أفسوس، أفسوس دي في تركيا، آسيا الصغرى. سمع عن مشاكل فكتب الرسالة لكرونسوس. It's very important to understand the outline of this epistle because it's it relates to us very much. Corinth was a very big church, a lot of believers and a lot of issues. All kinds of issues were there. So St. Paul is writing about all these issues and how to deal with it. And it's a beautiful thing to know. Because sometimes we look at problems or issues happening in the church and we start to be discouraged or disappointed. Guess what? From the very early on in Christianity, there is the enemy of goodness, the enemy of the church always fight. So there is nothing new. It's good to know that. It's good to know that the church is a holy place, is the house of the Lord, does not mean there is no struggles. But we have to be wise. So one of us, when we read the Epistle of St. Paul to Corinthians, you get encouragement. يعني واحد يتشجع. ساعات الواحد يتخض له في والمشاكل كثرت كده ليه والناس بتعاند في بعض كده ليه. Guess what? قديس بولس الرسول بيتكلم على نوعية المشاكل دي سنة 57 كتب الرسالة. من 2000 سنة إلا فك. فيبقى الواحد يبقى مطمن إن المسيح اللي في الكنيسة هو المسيح اللي في الكنيسة. فعشان كده القديس بولس الرسول he wrote to deal with different problems and issue in the church. أول مشكلة the division of the church. Second issue is sexual immorality. Believe it or not, sexual immorality is back then is there. It's not only nowadays. You're gonna see some Paul talk about homosexuality in Corinthians and in Romans. So homosexuality is not only addressed in the Old Testament. It wasn't an issue in the Old Testament and the New Testament. Forget about it. It was an issue from the Old Testament. And Moses in the Leviticus wrote about it. And in the New Testament, St. Paul in his epistles to Romans and to Corinthians, he wrote about it too. So it's worthy to notice. Then he talked about marriage and celibacy and how marriage should be and relationship between husband and wives. These are all issues in the church. And I think we all can relate to these issues nowadays. I think nowadays, احنا يعني كأسرة والزوج والزوجة ودور الزوجة ايه والزوج والست تعمل ايه وما تعملش ايه. قديس بولس الرسول بيتكلم على نفس الاشيوز. Talking about sacraments, number four. ده الاوتلاين بسرعة كده يعني we have to go through it quickly in 10 minutes, then we pick up a chapter. Talking about the sacrament, sometimes we come to the church, it's been like 15 or 20 years, some of us been 40 years, 50 years, and you take in the sacrament and you see no change in your life. And you sometimes you wonder, what's going on? ما أنا باجي الكنيسة كل أسبوع ليه 20 سنة. ليه ما فيش حاجة بتحصل؟ St. Paul here talks about attending the church and attending to the sacrament in what attitude. So he tackled this issue as well. And then he talks a very famous chapter. When we talk about the chapter of love, it's 1 Corinthians chapter cam. You guys should know it, 13. So 1 Corinthians 13 is the chapter of what? Of love, okay? And then he talks about faith in the resurrection. And this is usually every time we come to in any funeral prayer صلاة الجنازة تلاقي دايما في صلاة الجنازة البولس معلمنا بولس الرسول للأهل كرونسوس الأولى الإصحاح 15 chapter 15 talks about the resurrection. And then طبعا آخر حاجة الـ greetings and benediction. Okay, now I'm gonna sum up the whole 16 chapters in next slide. So all I said, we're gonna sum it up in next slide. If you remember next slide, I'm happy. Okay? I will give you, is it readable or صعبة? Can you guys read it or no? شايفينها؟ طيب. ده ال breakdown بتاع ال chapters and the issues next to it. So this is a quick recap of the whole epistle of St. Paul to Corinthians. And actually, if you noticed, I make it like a pyramid because spiritually, they are all related. I make a small like triangle, and then the base get bigger. So the first four chapters talk about the major, the cherry on the top. What is the cherry on the top is what? Pride and division. Pride and division. Everybody holding to his or her own opinion. الكبرياء والايه والانقسام. احنا المجموعه دي بتاعت الحته دي، المجموعه دي بتاعت ابونا ده، المجموعه دي بتاعت البروجكت ده، المجموعه دي بتاعت مش عارف ايه. برايد اند ديفيجن دي اللي على وش القفص، دي اللي من فوق دي. بعديها تجيب ايه على طول بعد البرايد؟ يو فاين يور سيلف فولينج انتو سيكشوال اموراليتي، يعني خطايا الشهوه عامه بتيجي بعد الكبرياء. أول ما البني آدم كده يبقى ناشف كده ومتجبر في نفسه تلاقيه يقع في الشهوة على طول. ف فتلاقوا أول حاجة سامبول بيتكلم عليها بيتكلم على pride and division. Secondly, he talks about what? Sexual immorality. The guy who married his father's wife. يعني his mom died and his father married and then his father died and he married his يعني stepmother. طب وليه بقى sexual immorality بتlead to what? Lead to family issues. So you see chapter 7 and 10, family and social issues. Nowadays our community and our society is struggling with a lot of divorce, a lot of depressions, a lot of things. Guess why? Because the abundance of what? Sexual immorality. Nowadays porn is everywhere, everything is okay, your gender is okay, everything is okay. Guess what was the result? The result, more broken families, more struggling families, more social issues. Now the hot career is what? To be a psychologist or psychiatrist or a social worker. You will never go out of business. Why? Because we have, every one of us have some kind of issues. And we want you just to understand again how St. Paul is writing the epistle. يعني الرسالة معمولة زي الهرم. بادي بالمشكلة وكل مشكلة بتودي على اللي بعديها. واخدين بالكم؟ يبقى الكبرياء وقعنا في ايه؟ خطايا الشهوات. طب خطايا الشهوات عملت معانا ايه؟ عملت لنا مشاكل أسرية ومشاكل ايه؟ اجتماعية عامة. واخدين بالكم؟ طب المشاكل دي بقى بتخلي السكريمنتال لايف شكلها ايه؟ So this social issues and this family issues, it makes sacramental issues are very hypocritical, very routine. فيبتدي سان بول in chapter 10 and 11 talks about the Eucharist. And he was saying, you know what? You are good in coming to church. But you're coming with the wrong attitude. You're coming not fixing your family issues, not fixing your moral issues. So what happens? You don't benefit, but you take a condemnation. يبتدي يتكلم معنا بولس الرسول على ايه؟ على ضعف الحياة السرائرية. ضعف سر التوبة والاعتراف. ضعف سر التناول. مش في عدد الناس اللي بتناوله، لكن في استعداد الإنسان للتناول. مش في قلة اللي بيعترفوا، بس في توبة الإنسان اللي بيعترف. فتفضل المشكلة اللي فوقيها زي ما هي. معايا؟ بصوا تاني على البيراميد دوا كده، انتوا خلصتوا كرونسوس كلها. فيبتدي يتكلم على weakness of sacramental life chapter يعني من half of 10 لغاية 12. طب ليه بقى؟ ايه اللي تحت دي؟ ايه السبب بقى اللي جاب the lack of this sacramental life؟ يبتدي يتكلم على the lack of love. خش على شابتر كام؟ شابتر 13. Love is the true engine of life. My relationship with God is based on routine, conscious, عشان to clear my conscience. I've been pushed to do it. I got used to do it. It's just a blessing to do it. Like in how much of a relationship you have, how much of love you have with God and one another, there is a big question mark. Big question mark. That's why in chapter 13, St. Paul is saying, listen, we're coming that far in the epistle. We're coming to chapter 13 because now we're struggling a lot with love. There is no authentic, or love is not growing. We keep saying we love one another, but we are staying in the same place. Okay? And this is give us to the peak, ba, to the peak. And where do we take this love from? And this is what we're going to elaborate in the next 10 minutes or so. Our hope, this is by chapter 15. That's what we will reflect a little bit tonight. Our hope in the resurrection and eternal life is the foundation. The foundation of my love, that I have faith in what? In the resurrection and eternal life. What's eternal life is all about? It's all about what? It's about loving relationship between the Creator and his creation. The cherubim and the seraphim and humans and the angels are together loving God and God loving them back. If this faith is not lived in my life, There is no way for me I can maintain love. Why should I love somebody who's giving me hard time? Why should I? No? Doesn't make sense. How come I will love God and I doubt if somehow we're going to have a real relationship with Him? So when this faith is shaken, لما إيماني إيماني بالقيامة ضعيف وده هنتكلم فيه شوية كمان شوية المحبة بتاعتي تضعف. لكن لو عندي إيمان قوي بوعد ربنا بالحياة الأبدية هذا الإيمان القوي هيسوق محبتي ومحبتي دي هتخليني أستفيد من الأسرار المقدسة ولما هستفيد من الأسرار المقدسة هعيش حياة طهارة في البيت وفي المجتمع ولما أعيش حياة طهارة هعمل إيه؟ هنقرب من بعض ومش كل واحد فينا هيتضع هنحل المشكلة من إيه؟ من تحت لفين؟ لفوق هنمشي من الـ من الـ من الفاونديشن نطلع نحل المشكلة اللي فوق لكن لما بنقعد ساعات نحل المشكلة من فوق في مشكلة ما بين الجروب ده والجروب ده ونقعد نتكلم كتير ما فيش حاجة بتحصل nothing happen why because we don't deal with the issue from the foundation chapter 15 and in chapter 16 the greetings طبعا والبنديكشن this is a summary of the epistle of St. Paul to Corinthians very important epistle because it talks about tons of issues that every church every time deal with okay so now I would like to just pick from the foundation for the next few minutes I want to talk to you about faith so let me close this خليني الأول So 1 Corinthians 15:33 Okay. Do not be deceived. Evil company corrupts good habits. طبعا دي يعني حاجة I think we all need to re-evaluate because oftentimes we think we are smart enough, strong enough. You know what? I'm going to be around the quote unquote not such a great people and I'm not going to be affected. I will take care of it. I will go to the party but I'm not going to drink. I'm going to get drink but I'm not going to get drunk. I'm going to do this but not do that. St. Paul answered this but this is not our topic tonight so I'm not going to get much. But I want you to follow the next verses. Awake to righteousness and do not sin. For some do not have the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame. Awake to righteousness. اصحوا للبر ولا تخطئوا. لأن قوما ليست لهم معرفة بالله أقول ذلك لتغليلكم. يعني هم اصحوا للبر. يعني إيه يا جماعة I will speak No, let me do it in English and then I do it in Arabic. Okay? What does it mean awake to righteousness? يعني awake. يعني awake to righteousness. We say faith in the resurrection. What do you mean by faith in the resurrection? Let me ask you another question maybe to make it easier. What makes a true witness, what differentiates a true witness from a false witness? You know, if there is a court system, I have 5 minutes and I need to finish the point in Arabic and English. Okay? We have a case. So you bring a witness and you can say this witness is a false witness. Why is it is false witness? When is a witness is a false witness? When? Are you allowed to answer or are you not speaking in the church? Allowed? Anybody can think? When we can say this witness, shahid zur. احنا دلوقتي بنتكلم he didn't see that is one condition or he's saying something didn't happen, right? He didn't see. طيب دلوقتي احنا every single liturgy we say ايه؟ نقول ايه امين 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 بموتك يا رب ايه؟ نبشر وبقيامتك المقدسة وصعودك الى السماوات we witness, we confess, مش كده نعترف. Okay, can I ask a question? This is the core of the issue. Okay, were you there 2,000 years ago? Any one of you guys were here, were there 2,000 years ago? You were with St. Peter and St. John, anyone? Anyone witness the resurrection? Anyone here physically witness the resurrection? So, how come or how can we become a true witness, not a false witness? We talk about faith. Huh? Faith in the resurrection. Sometimes all of us will answer and say, we all believe in the resurrection. I have a question. Are you a false witness? انت شاهد زور ولا شاهد امين? So, anybody come to a conclusion? How come we are not false witnesses? What proves that you are not false witness? You're saying Christ is risen. I will ask you the question, were you there 2,000 years ago? You tell me no. I don't believe you. What's your proof? What is your proof? I'm waiting for an answer. حد من الشعب عنده answer? That definition بالإيمان. And I want to prove to me that you are a true witness. أنت شاهد أمين مش شاهد زور. أعمالي يعني إيه أعمالي؟ كويس. ما أنا بغلس. Okay. Unless this is faith now. We talk about faith. Unless Christ is resurrected in my life is transformed. Then I'm not a true witness. بتكلم كلامه خلاص المسيح قام. Okay. طب guess what? موسى قام. Prove to me he didn't rose. You prove to me Christ rose, I prove to you Moses rose. ايه رايكم في الحكايه دي؟ انت دلوقتي انا انت جيت لي قلت لي المسيح قام، انا اقول لك وموسى قام. Do you have a proof ان هو ما قامش؟ انا معلش بلعب بيسموها الديفل ادفوكيت. What's your proof? This is St. Paul to Corinthians chapter 15. He's asking a question. And he's giving us a hint. Do we have faith? طب ايه علامات الفيث دوا؟ ايه علامات الفيث بتاعت الريزركشن in your life؟ ان انت نفسك resurrected. يعني ايه resurrected؟ يعني كان في حته نايم فيها and you wake to righteousness. Unfortunately, guys, let's be honest. How many times you come to Abuna or to your servant or to your parent and you say this phrase which I don't like at all? Okay? What's wrong with this? يعني مثلا بابا ولا ابونا ولا السيرفنت يقول لك ايه؟ يقول لك بلاش تعمل الحكايه دي. فالانسر بتبقى يوجوالي ايه؟ What's wrong with that? Right? All we care about is what's wrong with it. We never care about what's right about it. Does it really show something good? No. All we care about ساعات كل همنا لو هي مش غلط ايه المشكله؟ مش همنا ان احنا نصحى للبر. Awake to righteousness. يعني awake to righteousness. يعني witness, be faithful to the resurrection. Witness to the resurrection. How come that your, زي ما الدياكون قال, your there is a transformation in your style of life, the way you talk, the way you deal with things, the way you treat your friends, the way you treat your wife. في اصحى للبر. المشكله مش انت لا تخطئ. ده نص الثاني من الايه. لكن النص الاولاني الشهاده للقيامه. الشهاده للقيامه ان انا اعمل ايه؟ اصحى للبر. ده الانسان اللي عنده ايمان بالقيامه فهيعرف يحب. هل احنا بنصحى للبر؟ هل احنا بنصحى للبر؟ اصحوا للبر يعني ايه؟ يعني الواحد يقوم كده بعزمه بفكره ويقول ايه؟ الله البار يدعونا ان احنا ايه؟ نتبرر. لان احنا بنتبرر بايه؟ بقيامته، مش كده؟ نقول كده مات لاجل خطايانا واقيم لاجل ايه؟ قولوا لاجل تبريرنا. يبقى إيماني بالقيامة يعني إيماني بالقيامة مش أقول أنا مصدق أن المسيح قام. كويس أنت تقول طب قسوة ما الشياطين عارفين المسيح قام صح ولا غلط؟ The devils they know very well that Christ is risen but they never witness for him. And I give you a proof. When the devils try to come and say, you know, this is the Son of God, he tell them, shut up. I don't take false witness. You are liars and you confuse people. I don't take witnesses from Satan, from devils. So God doesn't want us to say, ah, Christ is risen. He wants to see his resurrection in my life. Danny, the devils can say, Christ is risen. They can say that, but they will never change their style of action. الشياطين تقول أنت هو المسيح ابن الله بس يفضلوا شياطين بعد عنكم يعني. فأنا بس خايف إن احنا نسرح في حياتنا ومكتر ما بنقعد نقول إيه بنقول نحن نؤمن إن المسيح قام نؤمن إن المسيح قام نبقى مش أنتوا يعني لكن نبقى عاملين شوية كده شوية زي الإيه اللي أنا قلت عليهم من شوية مش عايز أقول اسمهم يعني عشان احنا مش كده احنا أولاد النور اصحوا للبر هو ده الإيمان بقى العملي ده الإيمان القديس بولس الرسول بيقول هيخلينا نعرف نحب بجد ولما نحب بجد الطهارة تخش ولما الطهارة تخش الانقسامات تقل لأن أنقياء القلب يعينون الله فلما تيجي تبص على اللي جنبك هتلاقي انه صورة الله ومثاله فمش هتقسم عليه مش هتاخد جروب تقول احنا جروب بتوع احنا كلنا بتوع مين بتوع المسيح عشان كده سان بول في الاول شابتر اللي لهم انتوا عمالين تقولوا some of you was Paul and some of you was Apollos no تديكم ايه ال I'm 2 minutes over time بس بصوا نقراها مع بعض and that's it from corruption this is سان بول to Corinthians chapter 15 دوروا عليها بقى كاوت underline what's faith in resurrection will give me from corruption to incorruption from dishonor to glory what we do it dishonor our bodies or glorify our body when I smoke do I honor my body do I honor Christ or I dishonor forget about the question of what's wrong what's not wrong whatever you do what does it from weakness to power weakness to power from physical to spiritual from earthly to heavenly from flesh and blood to celestial body from mortal to immortal ربنا يدينا النهارده انتوا عارفين احنا في صيام العذراء في صيام العذراء لما زاحت زارت اليصابات اليصابات قالت لها طوبى لمن ايه امنت faith if you believe in the resurrected Christ Roman Corinthians chapter 15 what transformed in you look at this 5 or 6 I don't know 1 2 3 4 5 7 is your still main focus where نشكر ربنا كل سنة طيبين. It's very good to let our Bibles and these epistles become part of who we are. Who we are and how we conduct ourselves. So I would recommend if you, it's going to be hard because every day you're going to have a whole epistle. So it's going to be hard to read all the epistles at once. But at least if you're going to pick up something, I would recommend for you, read chapter 10, 13, and 15. 10, 13, and 15. Okay, and underline few verses that you like, and may God give us all to act to what God is sending us, to whom is the glory forever and ever. Amen.